But one day he got out. An empty book in hand. And that's when he let out. What was in his head? He couldn't hold it back. He didn't even try. He put his hand to the paper. And he began to write. He thought of his past. His sister and his mother. And all he could get out. Down with Big Brother. He met a dark-haired girl. He thought she was a spy. So on fateful day, she changed his whole life. She was a good friend who hated the party too. So they stayed together in a private room. They shared a common hate. One they could not avoid. And from the time they were born, they were told that they couldn't have a choice. Although it felt very strange, they felt it was time for a change. So they did anyway. Brotherhood. He wanted to get in, and he did everything he could. Winston got the book, and everything was okay, until some men in dark suits came and took him away. They locked him in a cell. He was hungry as hell. Was he night or day? The poor bastard couldn't even tell. They stripped him of his pride. He rolled around and cried. They knocked him down again and again, to the point where he almost died. In the ministry of love, it's where free thinking came to an end. By the hands of O'Brien, he was never really a friend. O'Brien showed Winston that Big Brother is always right. And black is always white. They hooked into machines.